Hi, my name is Dr. Gary Namey. I'm the director of the U.S.-based Workplace Bullying Institute, and I'm speaking to you today in New Zealand. All bullied workers, friends and family, and former and current clients of Allan Halse and CultureSafe New Zealand. Allan and CultureSafe are in immediate danger, and I am making an appeal for you to help him. First, a bit of background. Allan's been doing this work where he is the sole organization, anti-bullying organization in New Zealand. They are the counterpart to WBI in the US. We've been doing it 25 years. He's been doing it 8 years. And Allan attended our training and he is an expert in workplace bullying. Now, here's the funny thing. He's not a lawyer, and that's kind of a good thing, right? But he's represented thousands of clients in the quirky system you have there in New Zealand. The Employee Relations Authority is where the cases go to resolve bullying cases. Now, it's an inappropriate and inadequate place, to be sure, because no one at the ERA, these members who render these determinations as sole individuals, have a background in psychology, organizational behavior. They're almost all legal professionals. So the ERA is really a terrible place to resolve the type of workplace violence cases that bullying entails. But nevertheless, and despite that, because that's the sole place where you can go in New Zealand that the government has provided for you, Allan has taken thousands of cases to the ERA. He has a 70% win rate, even though he's not a lawyer, as I said before. That's because there's this obscure section called Section 236 of the Employment Relations Act that allows an employee who is bringing a grievance or a complaint against their employer to have a designated citizen, another person, a non-lawyer, if you will. Lawyers are too expensive. Allan is much less expensive. But the main thing is Allan actually understands bullying cases, and that's why he's so darn successful. Now, here's the point. That success has caused resentment within the ERA. You see, the ERA is made up of members who are politically appointed by the Minister of Workplace Relations and Safety. So they are political hacks, if you will. They're certainly not mental health professionals or organizational psychologists who understand bullying. No, not at all. Not at all. So here's the point. This small but mighty organization, and I think there are only three or four folks that work with Allan, is called CultureSafe New Zealand. It is your only anti-bullying organization in the country. And he goes all over the place at these three different locations for the ERA and present your cases, and he wins on your behalf. He's been there. He has been raising awareness in New Zealand about the problem of workplace bullying. He had a conference in 2018 in Wellington that we flew over and attended, and it was attended by politicians too. Minister Little was then, I think, Minister of Justice. Now he's the Minister of Health. This really belongs, bullying, under the Health and Safety Act, and it should be handled by health professionals. But I digress. We don't have time to go into the history. That's your history. You can study it. Here's the point. He's been lobbying for laws for a long time, but nothing has changed. The ERA is primarily the MBIE for mediation, ERA for dispute resolution, and employment court for challenging the ERA or doing something else. Now, Allan has represented clients, thousands of you in all those venues. And now it's time for you to fight for him. Right now, he has 9 MBIE mediations pending. He has 20 cases in the ERA and another 5 in employment court. All of that work, all of these years, all of the gains, all of the benefits, all the victories. And by the way, he has won the largest payouts in the ERA and employment court. He has beaten lawyers. And that's the point, isn't it? The ERA members are comprised of legal professionals. The lawyers are lawyers. They all hate him. They resent him. They don't know what he knows. He presents evidence that's so compelling that even the ERA members have to give determinations in favor of his clients. But that hasn't been done without a cost. There was an employer who was disgruntled and resentful and tried to pitch a fine at him, and the ERA fined him, levied a fine in compliance with, in coordination with the employer. And he paid that off, and that was rather small. But now Ranguira Trust Fund, against whom he has had 13 clients and resolved the disputes, but they continue to be a bad workplace where people contemplate suicide. And he reports on their severity of bullying and exploitation, and they're a terrible employer. And he says so, and he makes truthful statements. Well, now Ranguira has prodded the ERA, or the ERA has prodded Ranguira Trust Board. I don't know which. I'm not there. All I can say is together they have teamed up, government and employer, against this nonprofit, Culture Safe New Zealand, and this lone advocate, anti-bullying advocate, and best-known advocate, Allan Halse, to fine him, to levy, to fine him, that would essentially bankrupt his small but mighty organization. Now, it doesn't take much to bankrupt a person who's not committed to making a lot of money, and he doesn't have the funds. But they're going to make a determination in early June. The employment court's ready to render an opinion to follow along with the ERA's recommendation to fine him. This is nothing more than a disgruntled loser of an employee, the RTB, that had lost to him in a fair fight. But what has he done? What has he done? He's only got justice for his clients. RTB doesn't like justice. ERA obviously doesn't like the fact that Halsey's a non-legal professional using the very law that allows him to represent you all. So he needs your help, and he needs it right now. The fine is large. They're trying to bankrupt him. He needs immediate help. I want you to contact Minister Wood, Workplace Relations and Safety, and Deluge. Now, Minister Wood knows Allan personally and has personally thanked him for his various contributions to the MBIE 2021 survey process, where the MBIE itself came out and said, the ERA is flawed. People don't like going there. It's too expensive. It's too biased. WorkSafe isn't doing squat in your country for workplace bullying, whereas they really should. So long story short, tell Minister Wood, deluge him with the appeal to free Allan Halse. Call off the ERA, review the decisions, undo the fine that has been levied. It's crazy. No single losing employer should have another bite at the apple and try and take down the advocate who took them down, in all fairness, in the ERA process. Tell the press, will you please tell the press, and tell your member of parliament, prompt them, tell them this is ERA governmental abuse. The government is actually bullying Culture Safe New Zealand and my friend and international colleague, Allan Halse. You don't want to lose a champion like him. You can't afford to. He's the only thing going. So please, 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 for the thousands of you who have benefited from his work on your behalf, if you all just emailed and phoned and called Minister Wood, your member of parliament, and tell the press, don't let this pass in silence. That's what the government would like. That's my appeal. I hope you can help. Thank you.